Supernatural Jensen Ackles and Dr. Ian Smith.
Coming up, Supernatural's Jensen Ackles spies on Bonnie.
Please don't look at me with those glasses on. I'm already in 3D. Was so cute, the sheep. But I remember when we were kids, remember the Easter lamb cake that used to be like covered in coconut and the head was to the side?
Yes.
Oh, I couldn't, I loved that. Our next guest is in his fourth season as one of the demon hunting Winchester brothers in the CW Supernatural. And next Friday, he's battling a new kind of demon in the 3D My Bloody Valentine. Please welcome Jensen Ackles.
Lively audience you got here.
That is why the guy from Eau Claire came out, just to see you.
Is that right?
Eau Claire, Wisconsin.
I'll look out for him.
So you're living in Vancouver doing this big show.
I am.
And your life has changed drastically because you were living, in Dallas? You grew up there.
I grew up in Dallas. About the age 18, I moved out to Los Angeles. So I'm based here, but the show has taken me north.
Did you go home for the holidays? I mean,
I did. I went home, and actually, it was kind of nice. My parents built a new house this year and moved out of, I guess, what you consider my childhood home of about 22 years.
So this was
the first holiday in the new house. So we got a nice christening of the.
Did you have any emotions about that? About the childhood home going away?
I was really excited. It's like getting a new car. So, you know, you love that old car. It got you from point A to point B.
Right.
It got you to high school. It, you know, did all those things. You had all the memories with it. But then you get the new car, and it's like, ooh, what old car?
No, it's a,
you know?
Yeah, I have a few relationships like that. But
yeah.
When you go home, I mean, it must be fun. People are recognizing you. Life is so different for you, especially after this many years on a series.
Yeah, it's, when I go home, honestly, I literally just stay home with my family and spend as much time as I possibly can because I don't get a whole lot of time with them. Being that, you know, 9 months out of the year, I'm up north. So
what do you miss the most about being there, about being able to have the freedom to just go when you would want to?
I've got two little nephews, too, which is really tough to not be away from.
I know. I read something about one of the nephews, when you were leaving, was a gift for you, right? When you were going to be away shooting the show.
Yes.
Yeah, I love this.
Allie's going to kill me, my sister-in-law. But one of the greatest gifts I've gotten to date. Last year for Christmas, Logan, who's the older of the two nephews, his Christmas gift to me was to write me a letter every month of the year. And of course, he's 3 years old, so he couldn't write it. So his mother, Allie, would write it for him, and basically she would tell me through him, kind of everything that happened that month, and then attach pictures.
Well, that's, I think
so I got to, I got to read it, and I got the pictures, and it was,
I
got very spoiled.
Yeah. I commend her. I think that's
wonderful.
That's the perfect gift, and you have to save them forever.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. It's, I've got them all tucked away. So. It's
and as, now, is, are these little nephews going to be able to see your new movie coming out?
I'm not sure my parents are going to be able to see my new movie.
Well, tell us about it.
It's My Bloody Valentine.
Tell us about it. I mean, tell us about it.
Okay. So was the...
No, the way I yelled it,
right.
I didn't care for that.
Should we go back and do that again?
Or? I did.
Okay.
When it airs, see any difference. Yeah.
It's a remake of a 1980 horror movie, but we've done it in 3D, and we've kind of taken the old throwback slasher flick and put the new 21st century technology into it. So,
have you been able to see it yet?
I've seen it.
What was it like in 3D, a horror movie? That would be kind of fun with all your friends, when you're in your 20s.
Well, that's going to happen tonight, actually. There's a screening at the Man's Chinese Theater, and I think about, 5 or 6 of my buddies are going to go, and we're all going to sit there, and they're going to laugh at me, and it's going to be great.
You brought us a clip, right?
I did. I do believe I have a clip.
Leave it to your friends to keep your feet on the ground.
Oh,
right?
Absolutely. That's what they're good.
All right, go ahead. And
this is
it
a. This I believe this is early on in the film when we're still teenagers and we're inside having a party in the mine and I believe the killer shows up and we try to get away as fast as we can.
Oh, all right, great. My Bloody Valentine 3D, running out of a mine.
They're dead! They're all dead!
Don't, please don't look at me with those glasses on. I'm already in 3D, the way I'm built. Okay. That is going to be a fun movie to go see.
It's like an amusement park ride.
Yeah,
really,
that's fun. Those movies are fun. I remember going to see them when I was in my 20s. All my buddies, you know, we'd go out and...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Good for you. You're
good
doing
times.
Well. You seem like a fine young man, and I'm really
Thank
happy
you,
for you.
Thank you.
And Supernatural is on Thursday nights on the CW, right?
Yes, it is.
And My Bloody Valentine 3Ds is in theaters next Friday, January 16th. We'll be right back. Okay, you guys, before I go on to our next guest, Jensen was so nice to bring us something for Bonnie's basement, a jersey that he's autographing for our... You can go on our website, BonnieHunt.com, and he brought us one of the back of his director's seat on the set, you know, or the actor's chair, whatever they call it. But anyway, he is really nice. He's a pleasant surprise of a nice young man. I'd like to thank all my guests today, Jane Kaczmarek, Jensen Ackles, and Dr. Ian Smith. We'll see you guys next week.